The choir appreciates the choir's worked really hard. I don't know if any of you have ever been in a choir before and doing Christmas music, but you know, you start doing Christmas music practicing way back in October, and it seems like, whoa, this is early, but to get to this point, the choir's put in a lot of practice and time and effort, and so I thank you for coming this evening, and hear their hearts as they sing about the miracle of Christmas. I have one thing I want to mention, though, in our program. And this is my fault. I'm going to take credit for this, Lois. It wasn't you. Shelby's name is in there on the duet and the quartet, but in the list of names, her name wasn't in there because I gave you last Easter's. Well, Easter, she wasn't able to be here, so her name wasn't on that list. That was my fault, not adding it back in, because I thought, I knew that. I'm sorry for that. So, again, thank you for being here and listen to Miracle of Christmas. Once upon a miracle.
Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One is to be born, will be called the Son of God.
Expanding peaceful government will never end. He will rule forever with fairness and justice from the throne of his ancestor, David. The passionate commitment of the Lord Almighty will guarantee this. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you.
Thank you. will triumph with joy. Come see in a manger a dear baby born, born in a stable in Bethlehem town, the Son of the Highest come down.
Suddenly there appeared with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
Angels standing.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing which has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger. And they fell down and worshipped him.
Their songs of joy before the Lord. The Lord is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with justice and the nations with fairness.
That the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world.
You are the
and devout. And the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Messiah. Moved by the Spirit, Simeon went into the temple courts where Jesus had been brought by his parents. When he saw the child, he took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, let your servant depart in peace, for my eyes have seen your salvation."
Therefore, God has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
This is the story of Christmas.
The story of God's love for us.
The story of Jesus and how we can live with him forever.
God doesn't always do things as we expect.
But he always does them right.
The Bible says one day every eye will see him and every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. And all of us will be gathered together, worshiping Jesus.
All this because his incredible love. He left the splendor of heaven, became a human being just like us, suffered, and died for our sins, and rose again so that we can have eternal life. I call that a miracle.
Once upon a miracle, once upon a